Do you know that a laser-focused mind is capable of achieving any goal in life? Swami Vivekananda said, "The difference between an ordinary person and a great person lies in the degree of concentration." You may be wondering how only concentration can make a common man into a great man like Swami Vivekananda. That is the power of concentration. It helps a person to absorb the information completely and keep him or her stay focused. The very essence of education is the concentration of mind, not the collection of facts. We should develop the power of concentration and detachment, and then with a perfect instrument, we can collect the facts as and when required. But in our modern day lifestyle and in many of our day-to-day activities, we may be unconsciously training the mind to become more disoriented rather than getting more focused and concentrated. So in this video, we shall discuss one major yogic practice in very detail, which can make our brain more focused and concentrated, and which relates to the medical and scientific research as well, and that is the power of right breathing. So if you have not subscribed till now, I suggest you to subscribe to this video so that you do not miss out on the forthcoming videos in this series. But before we proceed, kindly allow me to pay gratitude to my guru. Om Ram Shri Kanhaiya Lal Sharmaye Namaha. Om Shri Gurve Namaha. So we all know that the focus upon the breath is of very great importance in traditional yoga practice. But a recent neurophysiological study has discovered a very vital connection between respiration and attention or focus. Now, let me explain this in a very simple terminology to you. You must have heard about the term entrainment, which is loosely connected to resonance. In the 17th century, Christian Huygens, the inventor of pendulum clock, he noticed a very curious phenomenon. He observed then that when two identical pendulums or pendulum clocks are placed next to each other on a wall, their swings eventually became synchronized, swinging in opposite directions. So this effect is also often referred to as entrainment. So these are also known as coupled oscillators. You can link many such devices together, and then synchronization automatically happens after some time. So entrainment basically means that two independent systems, they eventually sync in harmony. This also means that the frequency of oscillation of one system automatically affects the other system. So this principle is also seen when a healer, you know, emits healing vibrations to heal the other person. We all know the healing powers of Lord Buddha, of Jesus Christ, and that if anyone came in their contact, he would be healed. So healing happens as part of the entrainment process, as the lower vibrations of a diseased person starts entraining with the higher vibrations of the healer. So practitioners of Reiki healing or pranic healing modalities, they use this natural principle of entrainment and resonance. Now, scientific research has come up with a very startling study. It has found a coupling effect or an entrainment effect between the respiration or our breathing and the attention or the ability to concentrate through a brain part called locus coeruleus. Now, this locus coeruleus is the part of that brain which releases a chemical called noradrenaline. Now, in very stressful situations, noradrenaline, they increases as part of the fight or flight response to mobilize the brain and body for action. Noradrenaline also produces or gets produced during states of stress and very emotional pain. Now, the involvement of this brain part called locus coeruleus is also seen in cases of clinical depression or panic disorder or Parkinson's disease or Alzheimer's disease. So, when our breathing becomes shallow, there is a greater release of noradrenaline, which is basically a stress response of the body. Now, it reduces the concentration power of the brain. Now, this scientific research has established that meditative and pranayama, these practices result in increase in attentional or focused states as part of the emotional and physiological changes in the body. And this happens through the functioning of locus coeruleus. So it means when breathing is made deeper and relaxed, only adequate amounts of noradrenaline is released, which results in greater focus and attention of the brain. This also means that when breathing is regulated, the effort required by the frontal lobe of the brain to maintain focus and attention on a particular goal or a particular task is also reduced. So this makes it very easier to concentrate for longer periods without putting in extra efforts. Now, this may be a very startling discovery for medical sciences, but this knowledge is nothing new for our ancient Maharishis. Thousands of years ago, Maharishi Patanjali established a direct correlation between breath and concentration in his Yoga Sutras. Now, let me take you through the three continuous Yoga Sutras which established the connection between breath and concentration. Yoga Sutra number 51 of second chapter states, Vaya Abhyantar Vishaya Kshepshi Chaturtha. Now, here Chaturtha means the fourth pranayam. The fourth pranayam is that continuous prana which is beyond the other three pranayams. Now, before this sutra, Maharshi Patanjali has described that pranayama has three aspects. The first aspect is the external or outward flow, that is our exhalation. The second aspect is the inhalation or the inward flow. And the third aspect is the gap between inhalation and exhalation. So it is the transition between these two. It is known as the retention or suspension of breath. So the fourth pranayama is that continuous prana which is beyond the other three pranayams which operate in the exterior and interior realms. So it refers to that pure prana that is beyond the three aspects of exhalation, inhalation and the transition between them. So it is a process of transcending breath into the energy of pure prana or pure awareness that is underneath them. So this awareness of fourth prana, it comes only after working with the three pranayams along with the yamas, the niyamas and the asanas, which are the first three limbs of Ashtanga Yoga. Now, pay attention to the next sutra, which is related to this first sutra. It says, Tataha Shiyate Prakasha Vranam. That means, the veil covering the light of the true self then vanishes. It means through that fourth pranayama, the wheel of karmashaya that covers the inner illumination or our inner light is thinned, or it diminishes, or it vanishes. So here this word karmashaya means it is a repository of the effects of our past karmas. The individual impressions in the repository are called samskaras. And these samskaras in our karmashaya, they rise, they cause more action, which in turn lead to stronger, much more stronger samskaras in our karmashaya. Now, the third sutra in this continuation says, dharanasu cha yogita manasa. Through these practices and processes of pranayama, which is the fourth limb of the eight limbs of Ashtanga Yoga, the mind acquires or develops the fitness or the qualification or the capability for true concentration, that is the dharana shakti. The mind develops the capacity for harmony with thoughts or dharana or concentration. It is also implicit in these sutras that pranayama leads to the withdrawal of the senses or pratyahara. So Maharishi Patanjali clearly established the linkage between pranayama or proper breathing awareness and the brain power or concentration. And now medical science has validated this linkage. The practice of pranayama is the perfect practice for increasing your brain power and concentration and focus. And with a laser focused mind, there is no goal in life that is unattainable. A focused mind is the prerequisite for outrageous success in life. So I am your brother guide to prosperity, and my mission is to help you realize the dreams of your life and help you achieve something worthwhile in life for which your family, your parents, and your children can be proud of. We shall be discussing more such practices to enhance the brain power in our forthcoming videos. So stay connected.